who gives Olivia away today to be married? We begin this ceremony in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Dear Heavenly Father, today we thank you for the people that you have placed in all of our lives. We thank you for the friends and family that love and support us, that continue to inspire us, and that guide us on our path. We pray that you continue to watch over Olivia and Jason as they now walk on their paths of life together in love. We pray that Olivia and Jason continue to overcome adversity, support each other, and grow in love as we have all watched them do over the past several years. We pray that you bless them with health, well-being, and prosperity. We pray that the love that Olivia and Jason have shown to each other continues to inspire them to grow as individuals and as a family. We pray this trusting and believing in you. Amen. From this place, we take ourselves out of our usual routines of daily living to witness a unique moment in the lives of Jason and Olivia. Today, they join their lives in the union of marriage. To all their guests, they are happy to share this moment with you. They have known most of you for many years. You watched them grow up, you went to school with them, or you worked with them. Because you are the ones who have supported them and known them so well, it is only fitting that you are the ones to share this once-in-a-lifetime moment with. Jason and Olivia are pleased to have their parents in the front row, close to them for the ceremony. The four of you should be very proud to have raised such extraordinary human beings. For those of you who do not know who I am, my name is Joe Freight. I have the honor today of marrying two of my best friends. I met Olivia through college, and I met Jason through Olivia. I value my relationship with both of them tremendously. It has been a privilege watching these two navigate adulthood together, from living in different cities to supporting each other through passing the bar exam and the PE exam. Liv and Jason persevere. They are well on their way to establishing a family with the same values that their families have so obviously instilled in both of them. Liv and Jason are a living embodiment of yin and yang, opposites coming together in perfect harmony and balance. I've watched Jason's calm demeanor and easygoing nature bring Olivia's sometimes impulsive and restless nature back to level. I've watched Olivia's adventurous spirit and thirst for life bring Jason to be more open and curious. Simply put, Olivia and Jason work. They bring out the best in each other and make each other better human beings. They make a great team. It is only fitting that this great team solidify their commitments to each other through marriage. And now we are going to have a reading from Monty Rohr, Jason's uncle.
I'm Monty, Jason's uncle, and very soon to be Olivia's. And I'm honored to be up here tonight to help you celebrate this beautiful marriage. Look at these guys. They're just adorable together. And they made it very easy on me. The blessing of the hands. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when you fear or grief fills your mind. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children. These are the hands that will help you to hold your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it most. And lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching out to yours. For years, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch.
Thank you, Monty. We will now have a reading from Becky Starr, Olivia's aunt.
It's a great view from up here. I want to thank you guys for making me a part of this. I'm so happy for you both. Union by Robert Fulghum. You've known each other from the first glance of acquaintance to this point of commitment. At some point, you decided to marry. From that moment of yes to this moment of yes, indeed, you've been making commitments in an informal way. All of those conversations that were held in a car or over a meal or during long walks, all those conversations that began with when we're married and continued with I will and you will and we will, all those late night talks that included someday and somehow and maybe, and all those promises that are unspoken matters of the heart. All these common things and more are the real process of a wedding. The symbolic vows that you're about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know all those things that we've promised and hoped and dreamed? Well, I meant it all, every word. Look at one another and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you've been many things to one another: acquaintance, friend, companion, lover, dancing partner, even teacher, for you've learned much from one another these past few years. Shortly, you shall say a few words that will take you across a threshold of life, and things between you will never quite be the same. For after today, you shall say to the world, this is my husband, this is my wife. I love you both.
Olivia and Jason have chosen to write vows for each other, and they will read them to each other at this time.
I'm really regretting going first. Now I volunteered. Jason, I am overjoyed to commit myself to you today. I am thrilled that I get to stand here and choose you as my partner for life. To begin, I'm going to tell a short story. When I was in high school and Jason was getting ready to leave for college, he asked if I would go golfing with him. I don't think either of us really considered this to be a date at that time. For those who don't know, I can hardly hit a golf ball now. So I really couldn't golf when I was 17 and had never went 9 holes before. Even though I was making a complete fool of myself, Jason was patient, kind, and helpful the entire time. I know you remember that day, but what I've never told you or anyone is this. I vividly remember looking over at you and thinking, whoever gets to marry him one day is so lucky. I never thought that lucky one would be me 10 years later. I fell in love with who you are and the man you continue to become. You complete me in ways I never knew were possible. Your love and trust makes me a better person every day. I am so fortunate to not only have you as a partner, but my absolute best friend. With you, I have found my home and my heart. You give so much of yourself to others. Your soul is good and your intentions are always pure. Jason, I want to thank you for your devotion by making these covenants to you. I promise to adore you every day. I promise to challenge you and support you. I promise to respect you as an individual with your own desires and needs, though sometimes they may be different, but no less than important than my own. I promise to learn from you. I promise to keep myself open to you. Every moment I have had on this earth is a blessing because they all led me here to you. Our love is so special, and you make me happier than I ever thought I could be. Jason, today and always, I vow to you my love, my friendship, and my steadfast loyalty.
Olivia, take a moment to look around the room. Notice all our friends, all our family members, this beautiful church, all here for us. Now take a look at our parents. Mom, Dad, Jim and Buffy, thank you for being such an amazing example for Olivia and I. Thank you for leading our families with constant teamwork, for always being willing to listen, yet not too judgmental. Thank you for the constant support, the hand-ups rather than the handouts, always being available and forever loving us. Olivia, I want to build on their foundation. No need to reinvent the wheel. As we come to crossroads, challenges, or places of fear, all we need to do is say, what would Mom or Dad do? Livy, it is almost impossible for me to look at you and not smile. Think to a time when we got to arguing and at some point I started to smile and you get even more frustrated. I'm not trying to stir the pot. I smile because I know everything will be okay. You love to remind me that I know everything. While sometimes my words do not always line up, trust me when I say everything will be okay, as long as we are together. Here is another fact. You become more beautiful every single day. And I gotta say that today, you are on another level. Today is a day we will never forget. In this moment, I will cherish forever. Holding your hand as we take a leap towards our future, I have never felt more grateful. I'm grateful for your drive to be the best person you can be. I'm grateful for your selflessness as you give so much of yourself to others with no expectations in return. I'm grateful for your patience and ability to listen when others won't. These things and so much more do not come so naturally to me. Please continue to help me work on myself. I need you, Olivia. I need you to continue to trust in my intentions, all of which have your best interests in mind. I need you to teach our kids how to be the best they can be. But most of all, I need you to know that I love you, and I will always love you, no matter what.
All right, it's time for the I do's. Jason, do you take Olivia to be your wedded wife, to cherish in love and in friendship, in strength and in weakness, in success and in disappointment, to love her faithfully today, tomorrow, and for as long as the two of you shall live?
I do.
Olivia, do you take Jason to be your wedded husband, to cherish in love and in friendship, in strength and in weakness, in success and in disappointment, to love him faithfully today, tomorrow, and for as long as the two of you shall live?
I do.
Well, Jason's brother Eric, as the best man, has been tasked with the immense responsibility of holding the rings for this ceremony. Wisely, Liv and Jason have waited until the very last moment to actually give Eric the rings. Your wedding rings are the outward and visible sign of an inward and invisible bond which already unites your two hearts in love. Jason, place the ring on Olivia's finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
Wear it with love and joy.
Wear it with love and joy.
As this ring has no end.
As this ring has no end.
My love is also forever.
My love is also forever.
Olivia, place the ring on Jason's finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
Wear it with love and joy.
Wear it with love and joy.
As this ring has no end.
As this ring has no end.
My love is also forever.
My love is also forever.
May the wedding rings you exchange today remind you always that you are surrounded by enduring love. Jason and Olivia, we all could not be happier for the both of you. My hope is for you both is that you always remember this moment and what brought you here today. There are bound to be difficult times ahead, but with the foundation that you have built for yourselves and the loving community that surrounds you, We know that your lives together will be filled with joy and happiness. I'm so happy for you too. And now, by the power vested in me by the state of Ohio, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Jason, you may kiss the bride.
It's a beautiful night. We're looking for something dumb to do. Hey, baby, I think I want to marry you. Is it that look in your eyes, or is it this dancing juice? Chapel on the boulevard, we can go. No one will know. It's just run, girl. Who cares if a trash got a pocket full of cash? We can blow shots of petrol, and it's on, girl. Don't say no.
Of the bride, Jim and Buffy Myers!
This is how we do it. It's Friday night, and I feel alright. The party's here on the west side.
Make some noise for the parents of the groom, Scott and Melissa Phelps!
I'm faded. Honey's in the streets. Say money, yo, we made it. It feels so good in my hood tonight. The summertime skirts and the guys ain't canile. The gangbangers forgot about the drive-by. You gotta get your groove on.
Up next, Kenzie Packard and Ryan Myers. Give it up for Sarah Bolt and Brett Myrich!
This is how we do it. All hands are in the air and wave on from here to there. If you're an OG Mac or a wannabe player, you see the hood's been good to me ever since I was a lowercase G. But now I'm a big G. The girls see I got your money. $100 bills, y'all.
Alex Starr and Ace Warner! Put your hands together for Felicia and Grant. Oh, how sweet. Up next, Alexis Marochka and Mark Phelps.
Life show was slow, and all they said was 6'8" he stood, and people thought the music that he made was good. They lived the DJ, and Paul was his name. He came up to money.
Make some noise for your maid of honor, Kennedy Smith, and best man, Eric Boots! Ladies and gentlemen, I need you all to stand up. Stand up, please. Make some noise. Make some noise. It is my privilege to introduce Mr. and Mrs. Jason and Olivia Boats!
Was one as we sail into the mystic. Oh, I can now hear the sailors cry, smell the sea and feel the sky. Let your soul and spirit fly into the mystic. Where that foghorn blows, I will be coming home. Yeah, when the foghorn blows, I wanna hear it. I don't have to fear that I wanna rock your gypsy soul. Just like way back in the day, suddenly we will fold into the mystic.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time for Mr. and Mrs. Jason and Olivia Belt. Okay, it is time for Olivia to dance with the other special man in her life, her father. So Jim, if you could please join us.
When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be. And when the broken-hearted people living in the world agree, there will be an answer, let it be. For though they may be parted, there is still a chance that they will see. There will be an answer, let it be.
What a special moment. Brought to you by the greatest band of all time. All right. As a certified mama's boy myself, I know the special relationship between a son and his mother. So please, if we could have Jason and his mother, Melissa, come up here. Jason and Melissa Biltz.
So let me start by saying Mark made me not wear my glasses tonight. So I'm wearing contacts. I've got size 18 font. I still can't see it. Jim, now that we're brothers, can I borrow your glasses? Thank you. Good evening, everyone. I wrote it down so I wouldn't mess up. Good evening, everyone. I'm Scott, the proud father of Jason. When I rehearsed this, I told Melissa I was keeping it short and sweet, and she said, good. Because you tend to ramble on a little bit. I decided to roll my toast speech into the prayer, as I know there are many others that want to toast the bride and groom. So this will be the last time you hear from me. Yay! Let's hear it for that! I know I speak for Jim and Buffy when I say welcome. Melissa and I are feeling very full, very proud, and grateful tonight, and also send our heartfelt greeting to all of you. A little trivia, we've got friends here from Georgia, South Carolina. Where's Todd and Pam? Yeah! Georgia, Mr. Brown. And then we even go a little bit further. Cole, a friend of Jason's, since they were little boys, is here from St. Martin's. Pretty cool. And then the one that no one can beat, she's got like a 36-hour layover, I hear. Lena Snyder, where are you? Stand up. Oh. No, no, really, I need you to stand up. You're stand up. There you go. Lena plays professional basketball, and she plays in Germany, and she flew here from Germany for the wedding. Jason, as your father, I'm very proud to have helped raise you. Mom and I have had the rare pleasure of watching you grow from a little baby into a wonderful young man. You cannot possibly know. Oh, where's Eric? He was betting that I would choke up. Okay. Ron White. You cannot possibly know how proud we are of you and how much we love you. Olivia. We feel so blessed that you and Jason found each other. We're now connected. And we welcome you, your mom, your dad, Ryan, and Brett into the family circle. Congratulations to both of you on this, your lovely wedding day. Now, I'd like you to remove your baseball caps and bow our heads so we can pray together. Dear Lord, we gather in this place in a spirit of celebration and gratitude. Thank you for the blessing of bringing Jason and Olivia together in marriage today. We ask you bless their marriage, their family, and all of their relationships. Help them to stay strong in any adversity and treasure and protect the joy of marriage. May we, as their family and friends, commit to upholding and encouraging them to be the best that we can based on our ability. Please bless this food we're about to receive, and let this reception be an honor to you. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you.
Good evening, everybody. As the father of the bride, I would like to welcome everybody here tonight on behalf of my beautiful wife, Buffy, and Scott's awesome parents, or Scott Jason's awesome parents, Scott and Melissa. We would like to welcome you all here tonight. We are so glad you joined us for this awesome evening of two incredible people here. I'd like to make a special welcome to the Rohr family, wherever you're at. There's about 50 of you strong here, I think. There you go. And the Biltz family, for sure. And I know that there's others here tonight that also traveled very far. There's some that came from Florida. Brady's here somewhere. Up here, Kennedy came from Nashville. Kenzie came from Chicago. But Scott stole my thunder a little bit. I can't believe that Lena pulled enough strings to fly in for 36 hours, all the way over 4,000 miles one way to Germany, by the way. That's incredible. I would, from there, I want to start by acknowledging probably the most important person in the room tonight, and it's not Jason and Olivia. It would be Melissa, because without Melissa, Jason was going to a wedding, I believe is the story, and he thought he had an and one and didn't have a date. Melissa's the one that suggested Olivia. So Jason got a hold of Olivia. There was confusion. He had a date. He didn't have an and one. So I don't think they went out to the wedding, but then they didn't make it to that wedding, and they started dating from there. So, Melissa, if it wouldn't have been for you, tonight probably wouldn't have happened. So thank you very much. Over the past year or so, once the date was set, and I would talk to people in public, you know, people would question, why in the world would you have a wedding reception and a wedding on New Year's Eve? And for the record, those people that questioned me, none of them are here tonight. I think they were more jealous that they weren't going to be here. But if you think about it, New Year's Eve is the perfect night for a wedding. So when we go to a wedding, we're there to celebrate the past, the two individuals as they were, and look forward to the future. Isn't that what you do on New Year's Eve? Right? You celebrate last year and you look forward to next year. So along with that, there's a handful of us here who were at a New Year's Eve wedding 28 years ago, and I can tell you, and Robin confirmed it last night, it was probably the most fun I've ever had at a wedding reception. And that bride and groom are here tonight celebrating their 28th anniversary. Mark and Karen Baird. And there are two people here tonight that don't even know that they were at that wedding. So Robin was pregnant with Madeline. And Buffy was pregnant with Olivia. And if you know our family dynamic very much, that's probably why I had so much fun, because I wasn't the driver that night. Yep. She knows it's true. To Olivia, you know, I've always told you this, you will always be my little princess. And I've told you this before many times, and Brett and Ryan, it's only because she was my first. You have changed my life more than anybody. I will never forget sitting in the hospital, holding you the day you were born, thinking, holy crap, I'm in charge of this. What am I going to do? You forced me to grow up to be a dad and a man, and I appreciate that. And she was born on Saturday night of Father's Day weekend, and I tell her every year that she was the best gift I ever got. Okay. Oh, I'm not done. How you feeling right now? Kind of scared, huh? Can I, first of all, can I see the hands of the girl dads in the room? Come on, let me see how many girl dads we got here. Right? Right? So, you know my feeling. For 27 years, 6 months, and 16 days, I've feared this day. I really have. I have feared that Olivia would fall in love and want to marry a moron. We'll come back to that. So, as a girl dad, you know there are certain qualifications you're looking for to be able to take your daughter's hand in marriage. What Libby doesn't know, I don't know if I ever told you this, but I'd known Jason a little bit because they had dated a little bit in high school. But before Jason's senior year in college, Scott brought him into my office when I was still a lender. And Jason wanted to, he got some scholarships to pay for college, and he'd also been working his butt off because he didn't want any debt when he got out of college. But for his senior year, he wanted to take a break and have a little fun. So he was responsible enough to come in. He knew exactly how much he needed. When he came into my office, of course, anybody that knows the Biltz boys, he called me Mr. Myrich, right? So he's respectful, right there, check number one. He shook my hand nice and strong, looked me right in the eyes. I appreciate that very much. And I knew he was a hard worker if he'd worked to pay his way through college so far. And as a lender, Craig, you'll appreciate this. His name never appeared on our past due list, buddy. He paid, made every payment on time. So he's checking off the boxes. He's responsible. He's a hard worker. He's a smart kid. So when Livy started dating him again, and I can see, like Buffy has said, you could see a difference in Livy right away when she started talking about Jason. And like you said earlier today in your vows, Livy, when he was in my office and going through all that, I thought to myself, you know, there's some girls going to be lucky someday to marry him. this is a good kid. Well, then when you guys started dating, my whole life with my daughter, when she dated boys, I tried to keep a distance. Monty and Shannon, we just talked about this a little bit. I did what I could to make the boys feel uncomfortable. I just didn't talk to them, you know? So when she starts dating him again, I'm thinking to myself already, he's responsible, he's a hard worker, he's polite. I could see how he was treating you. He's a college graduate of Ohio State like me. Ohio! And beyond that, he's an Eagle Scout. So I know he's a great kid. And I could see the difference in Livy. So they started dating, I think it was like July of 2019, right? So late that summer, it might have been August, might have been September, Livy had her friends from OU come to town for a Bell Ridge weekend. And I will never forget, that's the first time they met Jason. And Joe and Alexis, I heard them having a conversation. Like, Alexis said, "Oh my God, Livy's dating her dad." So at that point, I'm thinking, man, I really got to give this kid a chance. He must be a good guy. Joe said, "I think she fell in love with her dad." So at that time, I thought to myself, boy, that's a great compliment to Jason, to be like me. But as time went on, I realized it's more of a compliment to me, that I'm more like him. He's a great young man. Yes, he is. So we're better. You two are awesome together. Incredibly awesome together. So I'm almost done, and then we can get a beer, right? I'll get to the end. I'm getting there. So I hope you realize most people probably think you're the luckiest man in the room tonight, right? You're the second luckiest man in the room. You know why? Because you got Buffy 2.0. I got the original. There's nothing like the original. Welcome to the family, Jason.
Thank you.
Love you, buddy.
Thank you.
To Livy and Jason, please always remember that neither of you are perfect, but if you work at it, you can be perfect together. I want to congratulate the both of you, wish you a lifetime filled with love, laughter, and endless joy. And this is a little something from last night. And please get that king-size bed and fill it with grandkids. Can you hand me my beer? Can you give me my beer? We're good. So a toast, please, to my beautiful little princess. Who changed my life forever, and to the awesome young man who stole her heart, Mr. and Mrs. Jason and Olivia Biltz.
Good evening, everyone. I think I'm lucky enough to know most of the people in this room. For those that don't know me, my name is Kennedy. I'm the maid of honor. I heard a rumor that you can't cry if you drink water. Olivia, can I have your water? Okay. So Olivia and I have been friends since we were little kids, later becoming best friends in middle school and high school. Olivia's favorite thing to say is that she wasn't cool enough until high school, but I and everybody else wanted to be just like Olivia. spoiler alert, we still want to be just like Olivia. You are the Smith family's third sister, my very best friend, and I am very excited to be up here for you tonight. Everyone that knows Olivia loves Olivia, and I've never met someone who actually has too many good qualities to count, but I wanted to share with you all just a couple of my personal favorites. Olivia, I love that you know you're a bad driver. Anytime the subject is breached, it's yes, I will pick you up. No, I do not want to hear about my car, and you cannot comment about my driving. I say, yes, ma'am, what time will you be here? And second, I love that you fully embrace being a crazy cat lady. Louie is and forever will be your one true love. I'm sorry, Jason. But on a more serious note, my favorite things about you are really your kindness, your humor, your impeccable taste in music, particularly classic rock and musicals that we both love so very much, your old soul but young heart, your intelligence, your motivation, your family and your friends, and the fact that you make everyone you meet better in some capacity. Isn't it funny coming from the same hometown as your now husband? I can't tell me that when you told me you were unexpectedly attending a wedding as Jason's friend those years ago that I saw it turning into this. And we still joke about how Melissa is who told Jason that Liv would be home to internship with Critchfield for the summer. And there she was just a couple weeks later helping to paint the front porch of the Biltz family cabin. Safe to say she won you guys over pretty early, right? We're so blessed to have grown up in a community that is full of lifelong friendships. A lot of people in this room have been friends since grade school and are now in their later decades of life, still laughing and having as good of a time as ever. And I'm so excited to continue that journey with you. I'll forever be thankful that you continued to be my best friend even after I snuck pet bunny rabbits in my purse over to your house when we were in preschool. Look at us now. Melissa and Scott, Jim and Buffy, thank you so much for helping put together such a beautiful evening. I love you all so much and couldn't have handpicked two better families to join forces. And I know that there are several family members on both sides that we wish could be here tonight that aren't with us anymore, but I'm confident they're all here, smiling down on these two and showering you guys in love all the way from up there. Liv, Jason, you both found somebody who makes you laugh, who makes you a better person, and someone who will love you with all they've got till the end of time. And through all that cutie and sweetie stuff, you've put on the best New Year's Eve party there has ever been. So with that, if everybody could raise their glass, cheers to you guys. We love you so much, and here's to a lifelong full of happiness.
FYI, I ramble, so I'm going to be reading a lot. Good evening, everyone. Thank you for being here on such a wonderful night. I am Eric Biltz, who some say is the better looking and smarter brother out of Jason and I. However, Mark is the baby, so he gets that crown automatically. I felt completely honored to be named the best man by Jason, even though it made me terrified to know that I had to stand up and give this speech today. Like I said, for those that don't know me or that have been around me, you know I am not afraid to talk. But for some reason, getting up here in front of all of you has got me terrified. I mean, I'm literally shaking right now. In all seriousness, today is not about me, the speeches, the food, the drinks, or the pictures. Today is about the joining of two people that I cannot love with any more of my heart. I could stand up here and tell stories for hours about all the things that Jason and I have done together. Hands down, though, some of the best memories that I have with Jason have been when we are in his favorite environment, the woods. Things like our endless kayak trips, camping together in forts that we made out in the woods, fishing on the Kilbuck Creek, and working down at the cabin making maple syrup. Some other fond memories, though, with Jason have been going to Ohio State football games, me being a designated driver for him and Grant, golfing, and even that time we ran over a beaver on 520 coming home from Corey Ray Martin's. With all these activities that we have done together, it has created memories that I can't even explain to people that we have had. It has made me so grateful to have an older brother as awesome as Jason. Now to you, Olivia. We welcome you into our crazy family. When Jason first brought Olivia around, it all started when he took her to a wedding that he was originally not supposed to have a plus one for. So, for all of you that are here, that might be here on a first date, you never know where things will take you. Jason has taught me the love of the outdoors, and I am excited to see Jason be able to share his love for the outdoors with you, Olivia. Between their countless camping trips that included a three-week road trip out west, to their proposal that happened in the middle of the Allegheny National Forest. All that being said, I speak for our entire family to say we are all excited for you to be a Bilt. In a marriage, from what I've heard, since I'm not married yet, one of the biggest things is patience with each other. The fact that Jason would take his younger brother, of 4.5 years younger, on all of these adventures of his, in my opinion, shows that Jason, you have way more patience than you give yourself credit for. Olivia, you have shown your patience for just dealing with the Biltzes and the Roars. With all the maple syrup, the haphazard lifestyle that we like to live, and the amount of family gatherings that we have in a year, you are always willing to jump in and help wherever is needed. So, to Jason and Olivia, I want to raise my glass to both of you and offer a toast. Seeing you two grow together as one these past 4.5 years shows us what it is like to truly find someone that you want to spend the rest of your life with. May your love continue to build on each other. Here's to a new sister and a happy lifelong marriage. Cheers. Now, before I hand this mic off, if you see me later and you have a dollar, have it ready, because I got a dollar on low.
When we were lovers, that brought a lot up. All right, let's do 27. 27 or more years. It's getting late. 25 or more years, quarter of a century, and the moon is or more. No. No, we're I wanna 22 years, 22 or more years. See it shining in your eyes. Some people got up. 2 decades, 20 years. Do I have 20? 20 years. I'm in love with you. I want to see you dance again because I'm still in love with you. Let's go 17 years, 17 years or more. Five or more.
'cause I'm still in love with you.
Three or more years.
You dance again, because I'm still in love.
Yo, I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want.
So tell me what you want, what you really, really want.
I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want.
So tell me what you want, what you really, really want.
I wanna really, really, really wanna take a dick high.
If you want my future, book in my past. If you wanna get with me, better make it fast. Now don't go wasting my precious time. Get your act together, we could be just fine. I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want.
So tell me what you want, what you really, really want.
If you wanna be my lover, you gotta get with my friends.
Make it last forever.
Friendship never ends. If you wanna be my lover, you have got to give. Taking is too easy, but that's the way it is.
What you think about that?
Now you know how I feel. See, you can handle my love. Are you for real?
I won't be hating. Give you a try.
If you really bug me, then I'll say goodbye.
I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want.
So tell me what you want, what you really, really want.
I wanna really, really, really wanna stick a dick high.
Olivia Jason, I love you guys so much. You guys are amazing, and I can't wait to spend the rest of our lives working together and just having fun and raising babies together. Even though, Olivia, I know you wanna wait a little bit. It's okay, I promise.
We're waiting a little bit too. Congratulations, you guys. It's been such a beautiful night celebrating you, and we love you. We're so excited to have seen this journey progress with you guys together, and we're so happy for you. Congratulations.
God. Congratulations, Livy.
Congrats, Livy and Jason. We love you guys.
Congrats, Olivia and Jason.
Congrats, Jason, Liv. Can't wait to see what you do.
Okay. Congratulations to you too. Just remember, communication and compromise. Those are the most two important words.
Hi, Jason and Olivia. This is Nana. Oh my God, this party is fabulous. I'm so happy for the two of you. I hope you have a lifetime of happiness and you just live and love each other forever. Love, Nana.
Happy New Year, Jason and Olivia. We love you guys very, very much. We were so excited for you guys to attend Lauren and I's wedding and celebrate in our festivities. And now we're here tonight getting to celebrate. And what an incredible wedding for both of you. As Nana just said, we wish you guys a lifetime of love and happiness. We know you guys were meant to be for each other. And we're so, so happy that we get to be a part of this special night and be a part of the next however many hundreds of years, hopefully, for your guys' lovely marriage. And also, we're very excited for the cruise in October. Love you guys.
Yeah, Jason, Olivia, I'd like to congratulate you guys. I want you to have a great marriage, work together, remember communication is number one. Love you. Bye.
Congratulations, Olivia and Jason. I love you. You had a beautiful wedding. I enjoyed it.
Congratulations! We love you!
Like a tidal wave spinning over my head, drowning me in your promises. Better let time set. You're the right kind of sinner to release my inner. Better see the invincible winner. And you know that you were born to be. Come on! You're a
Now give it up one more time for Mrs.